In this video, I'm going to show you guys how to effectively proof your PowerPoint presentation so you can make sure you have no mistakes when presenting your slides. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see here on my screen, just blank, and we can go over here to review, and then we have the option here in proofing to basically spell check any mistakes that you might have on your slides, or even if you want to use a thesaurus. So let's say we put in some sample text right here, and maybe I misspelled the word text, so I could say, maybe that's how we could spell text, and we can do sample like that. All right, so now we're gonna just have a couple of misspellings right here, and they're gonna be underlined in red, but let's just pretend that we forgot to catch these in our PowerPoint presentation. What we can go here is go to spelling, if we click on this, and then it's going to highlight the first misspelling and give you suggestions as to what that misspelling should actually say. So right here, it automatically says text. So we could either say change, change all, ignore once, ignore all, or we could actually add. So if this word is an actual word, we could actually hit add, and then that'll add it to our dictionary on our presentation. But in this case, we want to change it to text. So I'm just going to say change. And then for this word, it pulled up automatically all these different words here. And it also will say the word out loud if you want to hear it. So you can hit this and it's going to automatically say the word. And then another nice thing is as you're choosing each word, it's going to show you other example words that you could pick other than samples. So let's say you want to do example or test or taster. So in this case, there are no synonyms for sampy or simple. There's going to be humble. I can't pronounce that word, sorry. And then easy. So this is just a cool way to pick the right word that you need, or even a synonym for that word. Another feature that's really cool is, let's say you want to use a different word other than text, you go to the thesaurus, and then it's going to pull up a bunch of different words that are relevant to the word text and under these categories. So you can even search for words here. So let's say you want to say fast, it's then going to pop open a bunch of different words that will also represent the word fast for you. So this is a really cool tool where you don't have to go outside the application. You actually can use the thesaurus within the application, and super efficient, easy to use. And same with spell check. So let's say we had sample here, and then we duplicated this, and we had sample misspelled in this slide as well. If we go here to spelling, click on it, we can say change, or we can say change all. Here's what happens. If I hit change all, and then I hit okay, it's going to change that misspelling for that same phrase for all slides that have that same misspelling with the same exact phrasing. So that's really a nice feature if you don't want to go through all your slides at the same time and make that change. All right, so that is how you can easily use the proofing section to clean up all your mistakes in PowerPoint, or even use thesaurus to find new words to use in your PowerPoint presentation. If you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things related to PowerPoint, I do have a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. But without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.